Hey guys, so I want to reflect back on kind of my experience working as an intern in a high school in social work capacity. So this is the realm of school social work, social workers in school settings. That's what the realm is. And I'm not, you know, I think it depends on what kind of social worker you are. Like if you are employed by Department of Education, that's going to look very different to the type of social workers that I work under and with. These social workers are social workers of a private nonprofit agency. They're not government agency. They're partnered with public schools, you know, Department of Education schools. So they have a lot of freedom, I think, to incorporate their own programs. Although, that's not technically true, because it depends where the funding comes from, right? So it's important to consider that social workers are limited in some ways by the funding sources. If the funding comes from the government has some dictates that the social workers must abide under. You know, Department of Education social workers have their guidelines that they must follow. And nonprofit private social workers have guidelines they must follow because funding generally comes from two main sources, from government grants or from foundations. And where are these foundations' money coming from? From generally corporations and rich donors, right? And charity givings. So corporations and board of directors have a really big say in private nonprofit organizations. And that explains some of my frustrations in not only in just school social work, but in general, in the entire realm of social work itself. There is this thing called nonprofit industrial complex. I'm not going to get into that in this video, but it's a huge obstacle and challenge in the social work profession, I think. And just in the nonprofit profession, like human services area in general. Anyway, in regards to school social work, I really started it kind of shocked. Like, whoa, I never even considered this area of practice before. And I didn't know how it was done. I didn't know what was done with kids in schools. And when I was a high school student, there wasn't such a thing, like, in my school. But again, my town was a very small town in the middle of nowhere in California. I don't even remember if we had a school psychologist. We should have had. I mean, my school was a pretty big school. The entire population was like over 2,500 kids. So you would figure they would be a school psychologist, but I've never met one, never seen one in the school campus. Anyway, it's like school social worker and school psychologist, two totally different things. And depending on, like I said, Department of Education social worker, government social worker versus a private nonprofit social worker, again, two totally different things as well. I have been experienced with the private nonprofit social workers. It's interesting, I think, you know, being able to be meeting with kids, having one-on-one conversations with them, and just kind of learning their struggles and learning their stories. I mean, this is typical social work stuff. This is what we do in any field. We talk with people, we listen to them, we try to be non-judgmental and empathetic as possible, and we try to help them to the best of their abilities, to help them to, whether it be, it can be many issues that they're coming to us for, you know. In schools, they're kind of referred to us from outside sources. The students aren't just voluntarily being like, hey, I want your help. No, typically it's like the teacher comes to us. It would be really helpful, you know, you really need to meet with the student. Or a parent calls us, oh, this student would really benefit from being placed in one of your group therapy, you know? That's what kind of is the tricky for me about being in a school. Because the students are the clients, and also the family is the client. You know, the parents are the clients as well. But primarily in a school setting, the students are the clients. And when the students are the clients, they're minors. They're under 18. And so there's many things that, the type of social work that I've been trained in and the type of social work that I've been used to is the client is the expert of their situation, you know? And it's kind of hard to see, to have that perspective with clients who are minors. Because, yes, they are the experts of their lives, but at the same time, there are older people in their lives that kind of determine things for them. You know, what time should they wake up? Well, the school system determines that. They should be in school by this time, or they're late, or there'll be consequences. If they're absent, their parents are called. If they're absent a certain amount of times, there is an attendance worker that visits their home. All these kind of things. You know, an adult doesn't have to deal with that. You know, if an adult kind of talks with me and says, I don't want your services, that's a totally different thing when a kid says, I don't want your services, and I know it's like, wait, I know you don't want my services, I get that, but we still have to meet, because, you know, there are these issues that your teacher mentioned that we need to work on. You've been very... So this is not the conversation that I would have with the students, but this is something to kind of keep in mind. A student might have attendance issues, lateness issues, behavioral problems, mental illnesses, things like that, that they need to see a social worker for. And because they're kids, the choice is not entirely up to them. A lot of times they are involuntary clients. Typically with adults, involuntary clients are usually clients from, you know, ex-felons and ex-convicts, people who in prison settings, you know, people who've done crimes or trying to prevent, you know, them from harming other people. Those are typically the involuntary clients of adults. With students, they're just, because they're young, they're involuntary clients, typically, usually. So that's an interesting dynamic, I thought. One of the advantages of school social work was, for me, that the students are there the whole time. You know, when I used to work in Housing Works, which is a nonprofit agency that does a lot of things for populations living with HIV and AIDS and in need of housing, I was primarily interning with case managers, you know, providing case management services to people living with HIV. For the most part, I was meeting with people, older adult males, men in their 50s, in their 60s, in their 40s, and the biggest challenge for me was kind of reaching out to them and meeting them, because they either have to come to the office, which they don't do that much, or we have to go to their house or call them or try to find them somehow. So more than half of the work was trying to reach out to them or trying to meet them. That was challenging. With school social work, that was hardly the challenge, because the kids are there in the school. They're always accessible, kind of. That creates its own stressor, but to me, as workers, that was kind of an advantage, because we could make interventions right then and there. The only time it's hard is when the kids don't come to school, and that's one of my clients. That's his issue. He doesn't come to school. He has extremely low motivation and low attendance because of that. So that's probably my toughest case, because he doesn't come. If he doesn't come to school, I can't really do anything other than to try to help him come to school. You know, try to reach out to his mom. That's hard because his mom uses a government prepaid phone that has limited minutes, and doesn't allow for voicemail. So I can't really reach out to the mom. We do a home visit. She's not there because she's babysitting the granddaughters at a different home. So these are the challenges of school social work. You know, just kind of meeting the kids where they're at. And I like that. I like that the kids are there. The work is definitely enjoyable. This is my first time doing group therapy, or getting my feet really, hands really, hands-on experience with group work. I'm learning a lot. My supervisor is a graduate, LMSW graduate of Hunter's. Hunter College is a really great social work school. One of the best in New York City. It's, you know, in New York City, they're well known. Like, it's a very competitive school to get into, and they're known for group work. And so, being kind of working under her and with her, doing group work has been really great. Generally, I enjoy school social work. It's been fun. But I now come to the realization that it's not my lifelong thing. I don't think I want to be a school social worker after I graduate from with an MSW. There's maybe I'll do a separate video on particulars of why I wouldn't want to be a school social worker. But it's mainly comes down to this. You know, my view is that a lot of the issues that these students face in their schools stems from systemic issues, poverty, institutional discrimination and racism, economic inequity, inequality and iniquity, and just family dynamics and all those things like that, which are totally outside of school and school control. It's not up to the students. You know, we talk with the clients, we meet with the students, and we talk with the students. But when the issue is poverty, there's only so much talk therapy can do. And as school social workers in the school setting, that's like kind of all that can be provided. Case management is like so minimally provided to these students. So I feel like it's kind of frustrating for me to realize that what I'm doing is not really all that helpful for these students. What I want to be doing is making their lives better, addressing these issues of poverty, of racism, and blah, blah, blah. And meeting with their family and doing more kind of more meso level or even more macro level work. Whereas school social worker is doing more micro work. I'm not sure if I want to. That kind of goes against my kind of ambition. I want to have a bigger impact than that. I think that's kind of why I am shying away from the idea of becoming a school social worker for life. You know, that being my lifelong career. I really want to go back to my original passion, which is to work with the homeless. That has been primarily been my experience in social work. And I think I'm coming back to the idea that should be still be my lifelong ambition as a social worker.